Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Now for those of you who have been living under a rock, Power Rangers Dino Fury has finally premiered. And I was lucky enough to be given the opportunity to watch the first episode before it aired. So here's a clear warning that there may be spoilers ahead. So if you haven't watched the first episode yet, you've been warned. But if you haven't watched the first episode yet, but you're into the spoiler type of thing, welcome. So here we go. I love the fact that the first episode didn't revolve around the Red Ranger at first, like in past seasons. It actually made the appearance of Zato, the Red Ranger, more highlighted. But just like in the past seasons, this first episode just introduced the first three Rangers, Pink, Blue, and Red. We have yet to see Black, and we have yet to see the appearance of the very, very first female Green Ranger in Power Rangers history. From the first episode itself, I love the chemistry between Amelia and Ollie, played by Hunter and Kai. Their banter and their dialogue just seem so natural and fluid that I'm very much excited to see how the chemistry will be like when all five Rangers are actually on screen. I found it really cool that Amelia's job, even if she's a journalist, she's also sort of like a vlogger or a content creator. And being a YouTuber, vlogger myself, I loved how they incorporated that into the show. Now, this show wouldn't be a Power Rangers show without some fight choreography, and I love how the choreography matched the characters. Since Ollie and Amelia aren't really fighters, it showed their clumsy, comedic fighting style. And even in Ranger form, we didn't see them do all these sorts of crazy stuff. But when Zato came into the fight though, we really see how his experience and training went into his fighting style. Speaking of Zato, I liked how they showed his backstory and how he was a knight. I loved how the medieval helmets sort of was the inspiration for how the Power Rangers helmets would look like. This may only just fuel the fire for those people who wanted this show to be named Power Rangers Dino Knights, but hey, Dino Fury still rules. So from what I've gathered in the first episode, we are in a universe where the Morphing Grid and past Power Rangers exist. We hear from Ollie explain to Amelia that Zords will be part of their arsenal, information he heard from the news in the past. And of course, the Morphin Masters. I wonder if we'll actually get to know more of them in the future, hoping for that. I also saw a nice parallel with the Dino Fury storyline with the 2017 Power Rangers movie storyline, where the original Red Ranger searches for worthy successors to fill the roles of the other remaining Rangers. Just like how Bryan Cranston's Zordon, who was the original Red Ranger, did the same when he recruited five teenagers to fill in the roles of his old Ranger comrades. I really enjoyed this first episode and how they started the journey of all these characters. It wasn't too on the nose, if you know what I mean. It wasn't like these actors were acting like, oh, we're in a kid's show, we should act like how kids would want us to act. It wasn't kiddie acting. I honestly thought it was some great acting from Hunter, Kai, and Russell. Something that adults will appreciate as well as kids. To Hunter, Kai, Chance, Russell, Tessa, and Simon, congratulations on a very successful premiere. With great content like this, I'm very much proud to call myself a Power Rangers fan. But what about the rest of you guys? Did you like the first episode Power Rangers Dino Fury? Let me know in the comments and let's talk about it. So there, that's it for this video. Please do subscribe to show your support. Come and join the Cantata Clan by clicking that subscribe button. Again, thanks to Chalkline for sending me this awesome Power Rangers jacket. Hope you guys are staying safe out there, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.